Perhaps Ted will arrive. Okay, I will call this board meeting to order February 14th, Valentine's Day of 2018. Sure there's no place else we'd rather be. We have Barbara, Tara, Marcia, and Sarah, and I, so we have a quorum. And Susan Alexander is here, and Max and Bill. Are there any adjustments to the agenda before we get started? Okay. Citizen comments. Are there any citizen comments outside of the applications that we're considering today? There being none, we'll move on to new business site plan review. This is the change from to office space on 816 Atlantic Highway. Alan Beck, you are here.
I'm here.
Welcome.
Oh. Thank you. I was admiring your style of being off on vacation all the time.
Pardon me?
I thought you were off on vacation all the time.
No, last time I was visiting my daughter in South Carolina. Truth be told, it's visiting my granddaughter in South Carolina.
Yeah. That's vacation-like.
That's right.
Yeah. Okay.
Can I ask, is there an extra copy of it? Because I grabbed the wrong envelope.
Of the...
today's Mr. Beck's...
Of the application?
Yeah.
Yep.
Thank you.
I have what I was going to have you guys sign for the official thing.
Missing you. So don't write on it, Max? Do you need it?
Well, I was going to use that one as the thing for the record.
You get one of these, Barbara, if you didn't, that's yours.
So, at our last meeting, we discussed this relatively thoroughly with your stand-in.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think the primary thing we were asking for is in this package, which is the site map. There were also a few questions that were raised that... from a neighbor that I believe are fairly well addressed in the letter that's attached to this. Is that fair to say?
Where is he located on this map?
Oh, that particular neighbor?
East.
To the east, yeah, Ralph's Homes.
Yeah.
To the...
It's that sliver that goes along the right side and then...
The right
so away. It's to the right of this.
Yes.
It's right. To the right of the right of
way. Yeah.
Correct.
So relative to the, I do have a question relative to the description of the proposed project, which is, the remodeling of the duplex wouldn't, I don't believe, would be an issue for us. That's purely a building inspector. Converting the long, narrow roof canopy into storage units, is that part of this?
It's not on my radar for now, maybe a year or two down the road, maybe even less, but I'd come back, obviously, to seek permission for that.
Okay.
Isn't that just a CEO thing?
Storage? Yeah, I think it's an existing building. If they were going to use it for storage and just enclose it, I don't think you would need to come back for that.
Right.
Would that be storage for rental or just storage for
rental.
Storage?
For rental. For rental. Right.
Yeah, we consider that as an accessory building that's there. It's not the principal use.
Yeah.
If he wasn't expanding it and just using that existing space.
Okay.
If he made it larger or something like that, then that would trigger it.
Okay. So, but it's here as part of the description of the project.
Correct.
So the question is whether we should
just exit out.
Exit out, make it part of the, okay.
So you're saying I wouldn't have to come back for permission on that? I could go ahead, building permit, of course, to
it on the description, on the written part?
It's right on the front page as the brief description of the proposed project.
The brief description.
Well, the other, if it doesn't, is there any reason to exclude it from it, then, if it's...
You could leave it in there if you wanted, I mean, it's not, it's such a, it's relatively small structure that's existing.
Yeah.
And what he's been doing is putting sides, four sides on, on the interior partition.
Right, cement pad.
Yeah.
Yep.
I would say, I'm sorry, I don't have that page, I just have the building permit. So it's on the application, can I see somebody's application first? So, let's not make this too cumbersome.
I crossed it.
Why can't he get permission to do that now?
That's what I was just saying, there's no reason to leave that off and just, we can just leave it in there, and we're, we would be approving it as described.
Right, okay, you were saying cross it out, so...
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
So, yeah, go ahead, please.
I was wondering, on the map that was submitted, we might need kind of dimensions of the area.
Of that structure?
Of the whole area.
I don't think so, Sarah.
We don't?
No.
Yeah, I believe it might be in the, did I leave, provide a copy of the deed?
Oh, okay, so...
Yeah, the deed should be in there.
Yeah.
Reason I say that, Sarah, is the building's dimensioned, and proportionally, you can see to the left and to the right, there's more than 60 feet, so...
Okay.
There's nothing raising red flags about this.
And in relative to the width, all these dimensions, sort of give you the whole total.
Okay, all right. And are we assuming that the green area is long?
Oh, what's the green area?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that is all, well, grass and small growth currently, but yes, that's, there's no structures in that green area. There's trees, of course.
Well, I don't have any more questions.
Anything else? I think we went through it.
Yeah.
As well the last time, okay. So may I have a motion to approve this application for 816 Atlantic Highway? Well, did you want to, I mean, we can go through that also. I went through it already, it matches up pretty well, but take a moment, take a look, that's fine.
I didn't have any questions.
Okay. Can I have a motion to approve?
I'll make a motion to approve, the plan is submitted.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
All in favor? Aye. No opposed, all in favor, so there's no opposed. Passed, so approved, so we can, we're gonna sign Max's version? Okay, that copy.
So do you sign, I'll leave a space for you on top, right?
Okay.
Great, thank you very much.
Great, thank you.
Good evening.
Thank you, you too.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Okay, we'll just keep going while we will sign as appropriate. Next up is pre-application for 196 Simon Road.
Not here.
Oh, he's not here, okay. And that's not this, this is pre-planning, pre-application for 122 Atlantic Highway. So this we will, whoops, I'm sorry. So there is nothing for 196 Simon Road, okay. So we have 122 Atlantic Highway. This is also new. So none of us have seen this before now.
No, this is just a pre-application.
Okay.
Should we take a minute to read and then ask?
Would you rather have us read this first?
Go ahead and read.
Okay.
And answer any questions, or?
And 122 Atlantic Highway is where?
It's the property just past Dow Furniture, if you're headed back towards Harvest Moon.
So if you're going south?
The blue.
It's the next
Harvest Moon.
It's the next farm on the right? Okay. Oh, okay. Harvest Moon, which used to be the kitchen store, right?
Exactly. And so I'm Bennett. I own Harvest Moon.
Oh, okay.
This is Gail Montgomery. She owns the property and was also the proprietress of the Well-Tempered Kitchen.
Oh, okay.
This was the same that you sent to me. Okay.
If it's required for approval, then yes. I'm kidding, of course. In this day and age, you have to.
Yeah. That would be wonderful.
So.
Bill, can I ask you a question? We've been talking about a form for a mass gathering permit. But nothing, a form never materialized, right?
No, we're, mass gathering is not a use that we, that the planning board adjudicates at all.
Mm-hmm.
It's not in our use chart. The applicant would be applying for, we don't have an event category that fits exactly what they're doing. So the closest that matches what they're doing is a restaurant category. So that would be the use that they would be applying under.
Okay.
And they, most of their activity is catering and, so
yeah,
this would
basically
be on-site.
We're also licensed as a mobile vendor,
yeah.
Meaning that we can basically set up anywhere we're given permission, whether it be public property or private. So that's really the license that we would be doing this under.
Yeah. And from a land use perspective, since he's going to be using this on a regular basis,
mm-hmm.
He prescribes the times that he's going to be doing it, we would permit him, or his application was for a restaurant for that particular period, and instead of an enclosed area, it would be predominantly outside.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how we're looking at it.
Okay.
Like that. It's similar to the mass gathering was designed, was never designed to be used like this. It was really for a single event that occurred, occasionally. So that's why we have to find a use in our use chart.
So these folks are asking sort of for a blanket mass gathering?
No, what they're asking for is to use, kind of transcend their catering business to a physical restaurant use on a regular basis during predominantly the summer months.
Yeah, on a very limited, essentially 15 events,
yeah.
That would be all essentially the same event,
mm-hmm.
with a fluctuation in
yep.
numbers of attendance.
But what you would be approving is that, you would be approving his ability to use the space as he designates, and it doesn't necessarily have to be in that time frame, so he could expand it.
Mm-hmm.
If he wanted to,
mm-hmm.
as long as he meets, you know, the requirements for traffic and...
And my understanding is that this approval is only for a gathering over 100 or more. Is that correct?
With the way you would be applying, you could use it for smaller and larger, you know. It's not going to be...
It's a little confusing to the applicant.
Yeah, I know. I guess what's happening...
So skip the mass gathering language altogether?
No, I would just X that out.
What I did is basically I took the ordinance and I came in and talked with Max and Stan.
When he puts his application in, he's going to be discussing, for the use of a restaurant, he's going to be covering a lot of these same items. But for the board's sake, I would just X out the mass gathering. And what we're looking at here is a restaurant use that will be, you know, occur at this particular physical location in the manner that he prescribed. So he could do it year-round if he wishes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's a switch from catering business to on-site restaurant.
That's right.
Right?
And he's going to be doing both. So we,
yeah.
And this gives him the latitude to, you know.
Well, if it was a restaurant per se, we would be looking at much more parking information and parking lots and that kind of thing, right?
Well, we're still going to do that. You know, we're still going to do that. He still has to show that, you know, he's the one that's going to say, no, I'm going to have events that are, you know, this size, so he'll have to show the parking that's appropriate for that and where he's going to do it. So he's going to drive, what he's proposing to do. So I would think of it, you might think of it as a restaurant without walls in a certain sense. You know, he's using his infrastructure as a caterer, mobile facility to use, you know, this particular site.
So if we do this, is it for this year or is it for perpetuity?
No, this would be for as long as this is not conditional on it.
Okay.
Yeah, so this would be for, now so if he wanted to build a structure, you know, and do something, he would come back to the board or something like that.
Yeah, so that was a question that I had. What, you know, in terms of coming back, if we did make changes, at what point would we have to come back? I mean, obviously a structure, we would have to apply for a building permit, and then Stan would tell me whether or not we had to go in front of the planning board to get that approved? Okay.
Yeah.
But if it's
so
going
I would still
under,
sort of go through him for initial, like, direction of,
wouldn't
yes,
hurt.
I can say yes to this, or you have to go in front of the planning board.
I think it would behoove you to say, you know, don't apply right now for the minimum. Apply for what you would think.
That's
you're
why I'm.
Do.
That's
yeah.
why I sort of took the approach of going for the mass gathering because in my research it seemed like that would be the thing that we would have to.
Yeah. But if
that there would be an objection of, you know, I mean, we may have 50 people. We may, you know, and in my head it was like, well, if we go over 100, then we want to be.
I guess we want to be
approved ahead of time before that happens.
So my question is, if he has restaurant permit, why, if he goes on the restaurant heading, why would he have to come back? He's in commercial route one, and it's why wouldn't he just go to?
Well,
CEO?
Only if he expanded the business.
Over 500.
No, only if he physically expanded the business. That would be the case for any activity.
Really? A business on Route 1 that wants to put an addition on the building has to come in front of the planning board?
If he's expanding the use, sure.
Yeah, expanding the use? What do you mean? He's still making food. It's under a tent or under a building.
If he added additional seating or something like that.
He would have to come from the planning board?
The planning board has reviewed that in the past of different types of activities that have expanded.
Because we'd have to look at the parking and all that.
Yeah, things like that.
And drainage.
Stormwater drainage.
I'm surprised. I thought that the CEO could take care of that. Seems very straightforward.
Well, that's why Moose Crossing was here last month, I think, because the stormwater plan and the four greenhouses, we were going to have a huge land in.
Sure.
But it would depend on what, you know, maybe to draw a parallel, if you're, you know, sometimes you go down south or in the Midwest or the West, you see these restaurants that are all kind of like outside. You know, big seating areas, and that's basically, I mean, to my mind, that's how I was kind of trying to picture what he was doing.
Well, this is really, I mean, because we are, this, unless you would have proposed something different and larger, my conception of this is as an what it says here, it's an outdoor restaurant with outdoor seating.
Exactly.
And I know we've had the mass gathering, having nothing to do with you, we've had a lot of discussion about mass gathering in the permit, and there's not an official form. And our issue, I think, as a board, is we've made some approvals that have put limitations on the number of mass gatherings that a place could have, but we don't have a form that makes it easy to track. So we have a separate issue as a board to come up with this, some kind of way of tracking the number of mass gatherings that gets approved. That said, I don't see any reason not to include, if you want to do mass gatherings, it seems to me that if we're approving outdoor seating restaurant, that the size of the, and if you're going to, that could, let me just throw this as a flyer, I see no reason why that can't include you're having mass gatherings that are larger if you go and get an approval for the mass gathering, but at the inherent approval for operating as an outdoor restaurant for such numbers is part of this.
Yeah, I would just drop the mass gathering terminology.
What if he has a big event like music and like an Oktoberfest kind of thing? Would he get a mass gathering permit for that?
Well, the way that this would be structured as a restaurant, his capacity would be, it's almost like a seating room capacity. So he's gonna tell us, this is my capacity for an event, whatever that is, that the onus is on him to do. And you would approve up to that capacity.
Okay.
And that's why I would term it in that term instead of the, and just X out the mass gathering.
Okay. But that means that his official proposal should include some kind of limit size on the number of,
what would I
like
base?
The number of, I don't know, number of
base.
I would, you know,
for
do,
people, how would I, what I would ordinance look, would I look to for guidance?
All right, what I would do is work backwards in terms of your capacity for your subsurface system and your parking. You have plenty of room there, so he's got a lot of latitude.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if you would say, based on your experience, you know, in your, you know, in the catering business, and my largest event was X amount of people.
And they're not all at once.
Can I also suggest?
That's true.
Sorry.
That's true. Yeah. Yes.
Could I suggest maybe talking to the fire department? Because if you had to do like an evacuation plan or something during said event, it might be seeing what capacity is reasonable to get off site. I know we talk about life and safety code a lot, certainly.
Right. Well, and also as a function, I think what we're saying, correct me if I'm wrong, is that if you would just throw out like, oh, I'm going to have 10 tables and it's part of what we approve, and then you want to add two more tables, you've got to come back. We don't want that. That's not what we're trying to make you do.
Right.
But if you have a concept of, okay, what kind of capacity do I have to feed people or something, that you have some, you know, go through some process where you
I can put some numbers in there, and I'm going to go big because I want to be able I want to be optimistic. I'm a business person.
Yeah, Marsha, go ahead.
So with this, you know, I envision that you'll have tents in case it
We'll have a tent over our kitchen area, but I'm not going to cover, I'm not going to,
seating area.
No, it'll be, so in the event of rain, it'll just be, you know, kind of a wash.
So
but I imagine,
So if you wanted, though, you know, say in the future, every single time you put this on, it was raining. And you decided
then stop doing it.
And you stopped doing it. Yeah.
You know, that's the thing about this kind of thing in the summer. It is kind of hit or miss.
Mm.
So you know, we're sort of testing the waters again, so to speak. But you know, it is a large property. The Route 1, the location lends itself to a lot of uses.
Mm-hmm.
And we're gonna kind of see what works.
But if you put up a tent, you wouldn't have to worry so much about it.
But they're expensive.
I know.
And so are porta potties. And then you have to look at, I mean, I can't, from a business standpoint, we'll look at the whole thing at the end.
Mm.
And you know, as sort of a single unit versus, this week was up and this week was down and...
Are you thinking pizza mostly on those nights? I mean, is it like people are going to come and pick up their stuff and go a lot as well as
I'm hopeful that people will stay.
Yeah.
I really want to kind of create an atmosphere of
relax.
You know, hanging out in the park, having a picnic, people, you know, some community building.
Sure.
I imagine people bringing blankets and lawn chairs. So that's, you know, I think when we put some numbers on it, we'll be optimistic. And I mean, I would be thrilled to get a couple hundred people, and I think we could do that with marketing. So.
We can work backwards with you on the parking.
Yeah, I think that's the biggest.
But
meaning.
Well, there's some standard numbers that we use for per parking space handles
for
X amount of persons. So
okay.
We can help you with that.
Okay.
And I wonder if there's options for porta potties and the expense of them.
And meaning, what do you mean by options?
Well,
I'm waiting to hear this, Sarah.
I know. Boy, I set myself up for that one, didn't I?
It's kind of a tough crowd.
I was thinking of, are there, you know, the state of Maine has a surplus sale like once a month. I wonder if there's surplus.
I don't think we sell a lot of pork pies.
I would think the state would. There might be construction companies going out of business that might have their own porta potties. There might be a porta potty company going out of business. And maybe we could bring back outhouses.
Yeah, the outhouses, I'm not sure.
I know.
You get into some design
complications
there.
I think
the porta potties are the best way to, are going to be the easiest solution.
And like you said, if this is just guessing, but when you said evaluating at the end of the year, I suspect if it's a very viable business, you would make, you don't want to continue to have additional expenses. There potential for infrastructure building, I suspect.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, and we'll just, we, you know, you gotta try it and see.
Absolutely.
Are you going to be offering alcohol? Do you have
I'm not sure yet if we can or not, but we would if we could.
What if you need, like, you do bring your own in these outdoor venues? They'll say bring your own.
Yeah, the liquor is, you don't even want to.
Oh, we don't want to go there.
I mean, I don't think you do. It's very complicated.
Yeah.
I mean.
But do you already have a liquor license?
Well, so every year we have to reapply for our liquor license as a caterer.
Mm.
And the select board has to approve that.
Right.
Then it goes to the state. They approve it. And then when we do an event, we have to, like, say we're going to do a wedding in Damariscotta. I have to send a permit application to the select board of Damariscotta, the town in which the event will be held. They have to sign off on it. Then it goes to the state. They have to sign off on it. And then it comes back to us. So we do that for every event that we do bar service for. So it's
nuts.
Yeah. And it's interesting that the town that we don't even, I mean, it's an off-premise, on-premise license, if that makes any sense.
Mm-hmm.
So our premises are licensed, but we can't serve alcohol there, if that makes any sense.
Nope.
We can only serve it off-premise under these permits. So, and so the town of Waldoboro has to approve us to apply for a permit to all these other towns.
Okay.
We rarely work in Waldoboro.
So Bennett, are you thinking?
Yes.
Are you thinking? It's going to be one night a week, basically.
Tuesday, Wednesday,
May,
the beginning of September. I can't fathom personally doing any more than that. But you know, I would if it's. I mean, again,
right.
If it's, you know, we're sort of testing the waters.
So that's my question,
if
Bill.
If it's popular.
If this is going under kind of restaurant, should he just eliminate the one night a week thing out of his proposal? Because if he wants to do it three times a week, what's
the
matter?
Well, that exactly.
Except with the flow of traffic.
Fire language.
Yeah, there'd be more traffic.
And that's why he doesn't have to limit himself to the time frames, because he would be permitted. He would have the infrastructure in place in terms of the waste facilities, the parking, play, you know, the setups and whatever, so he could do them whatever.
What about DOT? Is that the entrance and egress thing need to be go by then?
He's going to need it for...
Because it's on Route 1, he's going to need a...
But it's already existing business.
Yeah, but there's a higher intensity of use, so you're going to have to check with them. You're probably not going to have a problem because you have site distance there as well.
Yeah, and the, you know, they have a history with the kitchen, the retail store, which is quite busy.
It's a pretty simple process.
Yeah, okay.
I was just thinking of people getting in and out and people like leaving all at once. But we talked about that with the church application, and that didn't seem to be a problem there.
My sense of this event is that people will sort of come and go. It'll be
over a number of hours.
What's that?
Over a number of hours.
Yeah, exactly. It's not going to be like, boom, it's over, and like a concert or something where everybody's leaving at once.
Church service.
So there is another possibility. There is another, it's not in use at all. I mean, the guys who play the tunes use it. There is another entrance. It's sort of halfway down the field. It's a, you know, a culvert is there. And so that is a possibility.
Towards town?
I mean,
Is it towards town?
Yes, toward town.
But that would have to get approved by DOT too as another entrance, which might be more difficult.
Yeah, if you don't...
And we'd also have to
put gravel.
I mean, a driveway.
Well, it's nice to have for long-term thinking.
Right.
Yeah, if you don't have trouble with the initial DOT.
Right.
You know, and if you have to meet them there to do that, you could always
That's not a problem.
Talk to them about it, but not make it a...
I do have a procedural question. I know this is a pre-application, but if everything's okay with this, can you vote on it tonight or not?
No.
You have to notify them. Okay.
Yeah. You're going to notify the abutters and stuff.
And that was the issue.
Right.
You did it like...
I forgot about
I was
that.
Sending it that day.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Sounds awesome, Bennett. Can't wait to go.
Me too. I was sitting here thinking, as long as you have gluten free.
I'll be sure to.
I'll be there.
If you want people to stay on site to eat their pizzas, Bennett, have you thought of having music? Live
Oh, that's a wonderful idea. I think that's a great idea. Music. I have thought of it. I didn't want to get anyone too excited yet. We get our papers in order.
Any other?
But I think people enjoy it, and I think, you know, it's a beautiful property. We want to bring some attention to the property.
So he should take out dates, really. Take out the numbers of events, the dates. You know, if we have another fall like last fall, he could have something in October, really. It's so warm. And take out mass gatherings, an outdoor restaurant for right now.
So a lot of the data he provided, we're going to need that. We're going to have to hone in on the number of spaces and maximum capacity.
So what's that? Is that a process that you're going to do some calculations and tell me?
Or actually, give us some guidance on what you're thinking of as a max number, and we'll backtrack it to the parking.
Right now?
Yeah. Well, no, you don't have to do it now.
Okay.
Just tell Max.
I'm happy to if it's...
Yeah, well, if you know.
He'll crunch the numbers?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
Or one of us will. Do you have an idea of what you're...
I mean, I think 200 people would be wonderful, amazing.
Yeah, that's not a large amount.
Okay.
Yeah.
But, you know, I guess in the interest of knowing what we can do... maybe we should see what 300 looks like as well, just for fun and games while we're here.
Let's give you a spread of what it would mean for parking.
And then if it's that number of cars, you've got to show the parking lot is big enough on the drawing to accommodate that many.
And how many pizzas you can crank out in what amount of time?
I'll worry. That's proprietary.
Excuse me. Okay.
So you should be, if you can pull this together, you should be set for the next meeting.
Yep.
Yeah, the DOT would only, can they move that fast?
We can always issue it subject to.
Yeah, we could do that.
You didn't say which march.
Yeah, oh, okay.
Yeah, there's a simple app, but we'll get you that.
Okay, so you can email me that stuff and I can.
Fill it out and proceed.
Okay.
They actually work pretty fast, because it's an existing one.
Great, and then the next meeting is when?
March 14th.
Okay.
March when? 14th.
Should be the 14th.
How many acres are overall?
92.
How much?
92.
Wow.
It's beautiful property.
It really is. I mean, I've known Gail since '08, and I've always really loved the property, and the more I kind of get to know it, the better I realize it is. I mean, the frontage on Kaler's Pond is exceptional. And it really locks in a lot of the easy access to the west side of Kaler's. It goes all the way back to the power line.
Beyond the road.
Yeah. And there's quite a, there must be 400 feet of frontage.
On Route 1.
On Route 1?
And then on Route 1.
Oh, on Route 1?
It's a lot.
Well, you obviously got plenty of space to do this in, so.
Yes.
Any other questions or comments? By the way, anything else for us?
I don't think so.
Okay. Well, thanks for coming in early and good luck.
Thank you.
Hopefully we'll see you in a month.
See you for pizza.
I won't be in a month. Thanks a lot.
Okay.
Thank you. Excuse me. Okay.
I was excited to hear your food might be coming this way.
So, next on the agenda is old business. We have tons of opportunities for old business, but while we were just discussing mass gatherings, do we want to talk a little bit more about mass gatherings? I see the, we've sent out a thing in that package of an example of what someone had sent in for a.
That was sent in an email.
Oh, I just printed it out. I see. That's how I have it. I just threw it in my pile of stuff with what you sent. This was in an email that Max had sent out. It's just from the land trust. It was the information they supplied for a mass gathering permit, which was granted on August 15th, 2012. And it just described the information that they had supplied.
I did see that. I read it.
So that was helpful. So I don't know that we need to have like a standard form that people apply on. That's up to, not us, but more to the, to the code enforcement officer.
Long term, we want to get it out of the land use ordinance and onto a municipal ordinance so that, and it should involve Stan, the fire department, and the police department. And it should be, you know, its intended use was like for a singular event. Someone's gonna hold a wedding or an anniversary party.
Yeah.
That's really what it's intended for. And what we're missing in our use chart is event centers and similar activities that have occasional large population events.
Yeah.
And we need some performance standards, you know, to guide that. So we ran it, well, you ran into that with Cider Hill.
Yeah.
With impact on the neighborhood and noise.
Okay.
We're gonna run into that in rural areas too, same kind of, same issues.
So is that a planning board thing?
Well, if it's an event center, yes.
Right.
Because that would be something like this, where it's a regular, you know, they would be scheduling these events on a regular basis.
But like an average mass gathering, someone just wanting to do a wedding reception or something, would just be a CEO thing.
Yeah.
CEO in emergency services.
So, okay, so it seems to me though, our issue was, do we have sort of proper tracking such that when we say, okay, so-and-so is limited to a certain number of mass gatherings, that that gets...
Yeah, we're gonna need, the best way to do it is a tickler form in our application, so that we have a sheet that says, you know, for 2017, there's a cap of 15 events, and when they occur, we tick them off, you know, on that list. That's probably the best way of doing it.
Okay. But that's still not us, right?
No.
No.
To decide if it's a calendar year or if it's a chronological year.
That's why it's best to get out of that. Yeah. And approve them based on, you know, it's gonna be a regular event, and the capacity of the site would dictate the size if it's a regular event, just like this one. If the parking is there, if they have the proper access, if they have the proper subsurface waste disposal or sewer, et cetera, et cetera. And as you mentioned, you know, the other safety issues involved, depending on the space, so. We have a lot of examples, because these event centers are popping up everywhere. And they're problematic everywhere, too, for the same reasons you've had problems with them.
Well, as someone who got married within the last few years, I can tell you they make a lot of money, so. It's very profitable.
So the question that I have for the moment, then, is there anything we need to do as a board at the moment for...
Event centers?
Well, for the...
For the approval, no.
Okay. So, but we might want to have some discussion in the future about event centers, is that what you're...
Yeah, that's, we have that in the comp plan as a recommendation to...
Seems like we need to come up with a list of terms that we need definitions and...
We need definitions for everything in the use chart, yeah.
What?
We need definitions for everything in the use chart. There's a gap in, we, you know, have a term in the use chart, but it's not defined, or we use a different term here and there, so that there's a lot of...
So how is that gonna get generated? Is it, do we work on it, or does it come from the state, or...
No, what will happen is, after the comp plan's approved, we're gonna put together an ad hoc land use committee, which will be charged to rewrite the ordinance on that. It'll be made up of, you know, someone from the planning board, board of appeals, conservation, it'll be a wide group of people on that, so.
And what is that committee to do, Bill?
Well, it'll be like an implementation committee. We just use the term land use committee on that. They'll be charged a particular time period, eight months, 9 months, or something like that.
So generating a list of suggestions from the planning board might be a good idea for this committee, or to work on, generating a list of suggestions from the planning board?
Well, that's why you're gonna have one or two members from the planning board on the committee, and when that starts, the board should submit a list.
This is for definitions?
Oh, no, no, for anything under the sun.
Like, you suggested that, I think it was a change to Article 6.
Yes.
Like that, for example. That is something that could be thrown to the implementation committee.
So it wouldn't just be the, okay, because I had assumed that the planning board would handle those kind of rewrites.
No, just a major one like this after a comp plan, you'd have a separate committee. Because it takes, one of the things that we need to do on this ordinance is, we need to make it more user-friendly. It needs to be reorganized. It needs a new numbering system. You know, it's kind of clunky. And it just, not as, you know, just discounting content, just organizing it in a different manner would help. You don't have review criteria for site reviews. You know, you kind of, you're setting conditions, but you don't really have the authority to set conditions for site review. There's nothing in the ordinance that says that. We need to add, those are elements, and you need to have like a set criteria that, you know, you base your decision on. One of them would be it meets the completeness of the ordinance. Another one could be, you know, does the applicant have the technical or financial capacity to, you know, to do the project, you know. So you would have some specific things that you would look at. The same thing when Stan issues a permit, he needs some review criteria. It won't be as detailed, but he still needs some method of saying, I'm issuing this permit because I, you know, met these 5 or 6, you know, reviews. So that's something that we're missing. And the other thing that we had recommended in the comp plan was to separate out subdivision review and site review. Right now, we combine it, and it's just kind of clunky, because subdivisions follow, there's a prescribed path in the state subdivision law, and we need to kind of define, you know, keep that defined.
When was the last time we had a since I've been on the board, we haven't had a subdivision.
I've never seen one.
Yeah.
But, you know, they're gonna come. We, in the plan, we had an inventory that Max did about where we stood on subdivisions, and we're at a point where, you know, that we're probably gonna start seeing some new subdivisions over the next decade or so.
Okay.
Maybe not a lot of them, but you'll start to see them on that.
And tiny houses.
And tiny houses.
Well, there'll be small subdivisions.
Small subdivisions, really tiny.
Actually, they amended the building code, the state building code.
Yeah, that's what I had it on my list, because I saw that, and I thought that was potentially a good thing.
Yeah, it's still subject to town, you know, the towns prescribe some minimum, you know, sizes and things like that, mm-hmm. so it's still subject to some zoning, so we would have to look at that. But you're right, it could be an ideal way of dealing with the housing shortage. A lot of people like smaller homes.
I saw one for rent for $800 a month.
Wow.
The size of this. You know? Like, wow.
Okay.
It's all atmosphere.
Okay.
It's actually pretty cheap.
So we get to cross something off our action item list for the board without doing anything. So that's always helpful.
What are you crossing off?
That the planning board doesn't have an action item relative to mass gathering permits.
You were never charged to issuing those. Anyway.
It's in the definitions, but it's not. It needs to be sort of part of town policy, right? Is that how it works?
Well, it's in the land use ordinance,
right.
But it doesn't make it to the use chart, so we don't have any connection to
right.
to review. It's just there.
Right. Well, I knew we didn't need to approve any of them. It was just the concern about tracking and that they're you know some kind of standard mechanism
you use
to make sure
because
they have.
That's all you had.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that, but it's not.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah. The only other old business that I'm aware of, well, we have, there's a lot of things we could talk about, but primarily we have the
Shoreland.
The Shoreland and the non-conforming Article 10 and Article 7. Which we don't have the latest to look at tonight, do we?
I can check in my office to see if I have enough copies.
Can I be selfish and just suggest that
it's
we
Valentine's
not?
Well, I was going there for the point
we should
starting it. It's if we're going to do that, but and we lost our special meeting
that one
last week, so. I was going to propose that we just set up another meeting to talk about it specifically. Is that where you were angling?
Can we do that as soon as possible?
Yes.
We have to start a public hearing process fairly quickly.
For
the change.
You mean after we get the changes?
Yeah.
Well, I was going to propose that we do it on the 28th, 2 weeks, which would then give us 2 weeks between that meeting and the March regular board meeting so that they wouldn't be one, you know, we wouldn't have them back-to-back weeks.
That's fine. 28th is the
something's to
Business Association night. The last Wednesday always is, but.
So you're saying you can't attend?
I'd rather not.
Business Association.
I have something on the calendar for the 20th. I'm not sure what it is, though. It could be during the day.
I can if we need quorum, but I don't want to. I know people really want to be here, so I don't.
What's that?
I said I can if we need quorum, but I know that other people really won't want to be here for that.
For the Shoreland?
Yeah.
Barbara, what time does the Business Association meeting start?
6.
Oh, it's right at the same time.
I was thinking, well, what if we met at 5? Could we get enough of it out of the way so you could go to the business meeting also?
Can you get here by 5?
I can, generally speaking, with enough notice.
I don't know about Ted and Laura.
Or the 7th. 28th or the 7th.
Well, I guess the question is, Bill, can we wait till the 7th? Because you,
yeah.
Didn't you say it needed to be done soon?
Yeah, as long as we can get it wrapped up on the 7th, sure.
Oh, okay. So the only problem might be is if we have a storm on the 7th.
True.
So
let's set up an alternative date right now if we do have a storm so we can.
Okay.
Can we do it like another day that week, potentially? The 7th is a Wednesday. Can we potentially do it Thursday? If there is a storm, the 8th?
Well, if Thursday was good, we could also do the March 1st would work for me, too, if we could do a Thursday. It doesn't have to be. I don't know is Thursdays bad for people or okay? Well, then Barbara would have to do 2 nights in a row, so that's. Well,
your
that
life
was a
is
throwaway.
Exciting as mine is. Excellent.
Exactly.
So would you rather have 2 weeks in a row or do a meeting on a Thursday?
Let's do Thursday with the snow date of the 7th.
Okay.
So we're saying 3,
the
1st
of March?
March
3,
1.
Okay.
Yeah.
So.
At 6?
Yep.
March 1st.
At 6 still? Or 5?
Yeah, 6.
6 p.m.
Snow date on the 7th.
Max, did you hand out? I missed the last Shoreland meeting, and I'm wondering if I've got all the latest additions. Do you know if you handed out anything new for that meeting?
I don't believe I've sent out anything new.
You've sent something with my editorial suggestions.
I think it might have been 7. Yes, I think it was 7 because there was a suggestion. I always forget if it was just you and Scott or if it was everyone else. I believe it was the suggestion that had a proposal to change a specific section to include approved by planning board, but I think that was it. I can double check what I sent when I am in front of my email tomorrow.
Okay. Well.
And is this Article 7 or is this Article 10?
Maybe has that. I can
Article
look.
10 we haven't touched.
Article 10 we haven't touched at all.
Right. I thought Article 7, Susan's issues were mostly referenced.
Reference based
of where it was referring to other sections and articles.
Well, that's
making
something
sure
we were going to do at the end.
Yeah.
Because
yes.
There's a lot of that. That
right.
I've got a copy of Article 10 that says it was sent on the 10th of January.
That might read.
With my changes supposedly in red, although it didn't come out in red.
Well, we have,
but they were highlighted.
Article 10.
Yeah.
Right.
So many of those changes we haven't even addressed yet.
Yeah. Let me just throw this out there, because my preference with these is to look at hard copy,
mm-hmm.
and my preference is not to reprint all of it at home. So
yes.
My preference is. You bring the latest that you that you've got.
Article 10?
Of Article 10 and Article 7. I think we haven't done much on Article 10, but it's not that long, and we also don't have a lot of fundamental. There's not a lot of fundamental changes to it. Article 7 we've spent a lot of time on already, so I'm pretty hopeful that we can within a couple hours we can get both of them done. There may be some references to other articles and places that might need to get resolved, but I think that's a
we'll mail them out before the meeting so you can have them beforehand.
Yeah,
that's
great.
Try to do that at
that'd
the meeting.
That'd be great.
Yeah, it's just going to be
that'd be great because all my stuff is
Last is dated September.
Yeah.
So you're gonna mail out hard copies?
I will mail out hard copies of Article 10 and Article 7.
Awesome.
And it will say at the top, use this copy only.
Thank you.
Well, just say for.
Yeah.
March 1st meeting, you know, like.
Big bold letters, yeah.
Okay, that'll be good. Okay.
Are we also reviewing Article 6? I have in mind, I have heard about Article 6, 7, and 10.
Article 6, I believe, is.
Isn't that just the one sentence you included?
Is the section on waiver provisions.
Yeah, that was just.
That would have to be.
Well, I added a section to a waiver provision section that's, I don't.
I sent out, yeah.
That Bill sent out.
Yeah.
And, but you're telling me that that's best to be part of the whole, changing of the whole thing after the, or can, should we?
We could do that now.
We can do that.
Because we're, all we're doing is removing the existing waiver provision and adding a new one.
You're talking about site plan and subdivision review?
Yeah.
What Article 6 is.
Yeah, yeah. So.
We'll send that out.
So include that.
Yeah.
So I think we should start with 7. Maybe we should start with 10, but try to get 7 and 10 done. If we can get 6, if we get to 6, we can get to.
We've been pushing 10 off since January.
A long time, yeah.
December, I think.
Yep, okay. Well, once, we can decide on the order after, when we get to the meeting. Because when we all have a chance to look at them, we can decide which one we want to tackle first.
Yep.
Okay, great. Let's see. Other old business.
Should be, yeah, but they were speaking of, I got to change.
Max, one of the things that's, that I'm still hoping for at some point, if you have time, is the, is large, the larger zone, the larger maps. The maps that we've got in our books are really small.
Yep.
We're gonna see if you can print out larger ones.
Land use.
You mean for meetings?
The zone maps that are in our.
For meetings, though, like mount them on a board, or how?
No, I just mean in our, you know, I have an 8.5 by 11s of the zoning maps here.
Right, so we have.
There isn't enough size up.
I'd like to have an 11 by 17. Double the size would, nearly double the size would help a lot when I'm looking at them.
Folded to become 8.5 by 11.
Well, 11 by 17, you can.
At least distinguish.
You can put, fold it and put holes in one end and fit it, fold it in half and fit it in the book. Works pretty well.
The ones that we do have mounted are so color faded, you can't even read them.
I don't see anything else on the, oh, I only, well, this is not old business, this could be new business. Okay, I don't think I have anything else under old business that we need to talk about tonight. Anything else on old business?
Old business, no.
Okay, minutes, we have, we're down to having minutes of only one meeting to look at, which is a plus. And. The one that came out in the package, there was one edit to that I sent out by email. I don't know if everybody got a chance to look at that.
I have an extra copy if anybody wants to look at it.
So.
I was there, I know I read it.
So I now, so I made some correct, I made a correction to the minutes. Because in section 6, what does yours say, the one? In section 6, which is the very end.
The mass gathering?
Under mass gatherings, the planning board chairman's comments, right? So I had made a correction to that because Susan in the minutes said that I suggested deleting the mass gatherings from the land use ordinance. And I didn't suggest that. And I wrote, and I gave a correction. And so that paragraph now reads, Simpson said there is no standard form for applications for mass gathering permits. Napower said that there used to be such a form. Applicants need a permit from the code enforcement officer, but there is no form being used now. Simpson suggested that we consider having a standard form created and required use by the CEO. He thinks the police chief and the fire chief should be included for required sign-offs. That was my recollection of what I said. Hearing Bill's comment tonight about the mass gathering permits made me remember that at the last meeting, Bill said that the mass gathering permits should be taken out of the land use ordinance. But I know I didn't say it, so I had Susan delete it. But after I made my comments,
yeah.
I guess my first question is, does what I just read match people's recollection of what I said? Because my recollection of what I said doesn't matter. What matters is what people heard. Does that?
Doesn't seem wacky.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I think that's, so my recollection is I said that, but then I believe Bill also made the same comment then that he did tonight, which that is that the mass gathering permits shouldn't be part of that anyway, because it's not part of what we have purview over, right? So.
Yeah, that wasn't the first time we talked about that.
Okay. So that means that these minutes are, this part of this, of the minutes are accurate, but they're incomplete if we want to include Bill's comment. Bill made the comment tonight, so I'm assuming it's going to be in tonight's minutes. So do we want to modify these minutes further, or
well,
do we want to just...
The minutes should reflect what happened, then.
Not yes.
Like it's
yeah, there
was correct.
A resolution
amended
or anything.
Right, today. There was no resolution, right.
But a mass gathering is a land use, so why shouldn't it be in
it's
the land
not,
use
it's
ordinance?
Not land
it's not a land use?
No, it's not.
It shouldn't
be
in the
it shouldn't be.
So...
But if we're using it as a tool, why
right
wouldn't there be some...
Are.
Some connection. Well, you're saying that, we're not at the comprehensive plan and the next committee. I mean, it's going to be 2 years till it gets changed from the ordinance.
It's going to take that time. Well, it's going to take that time to take it out, but we need to, it's something we need to address as quickly as possible, actually.
The mass gathering thing, you mean?
Well, the whole idea, the lack
that's
of an event center, because yeah. We're going to see more of those.
And can we address it before the comprehensive plan and the next committee figures all this stuff out? Is that what you're saying? We can deal with it earlier?
Hopefully, though, if the plan gets... let's talk about that in a minute, because we're talking about the minutes.
Okay.
Right. So, can we approve the minutes? I'm waiting for you.
Well, the question is whether we should add back Bill's comment into these meeting minutes that mass gatherings... He's suggesting mass gatherings should be removed from the LUO.
Did he make that suggestion?
He made that comment after I made my comment, so.
Last time. Well, I think that if he made that comment last time out, then it should be added back.
Okay.
I don't see it being critical to anything. It's not critical to the state of mass gathering.
I can check the video if this is that important, but
I'm just saying if he remembers that he said that,
yeah.
Then I don't mind putting it back. But
so if you want to make a motion to that effect, we can just amend the we can approve the minutes with that
okay.
Amendment.
Is that what the group wants to put?
I mean, it's not critical, but we might as well since we've spent this much time talking about them, also make it.
Mass permit should be taken out of the land use ordinance. You want that sentence?
Right. That, right. It's not an exact sentence that's in here. It just said, Knappauer suggested deleting mass gatherings from the land use ordinance. That would be the sentence I would add to after my comments here under section six.
I make a.
So we're
I'm
adding. Sarah, who's perpetually confused, we're adding your new revised paragraph as you read it,
right.
Plus
which Susan already has,
okay,
because
right.
Which you've already distributed to the group,
yes,
on
by
the
email,
third,
right?
Yeah, we're adding
okay.
That version,
yes.
Plus, Bill's comment about the mass gathering should be taken out of the land use.
Yes.
Okay.
And Marcia made them.
Amendment to.
Made the motion.
Motion to.
That we approve as amended.
Who seconded the motion?
I'll second it.
Motion made and seconded to approve the minutes as amended. All in favor? All opposed? Motion carried. Okay.
Let's get the heck out of here.
Okay, hold on. Hold on.
It's early yet. This would be a record if we left.
I know.
24 hours.
You must be exhausted.
Okay. All righty, so now, Max, town planner's report.
The grooming business that was here last month, she's right now in a state of limbo because of the state. So I can't say whether or not she'll be here next month.
Okay.
There's another business that'll likely be here in April, but I think other than that, for March's planning board meeting, the restaurant's pretty much all I've heard so far.
Okay.
I didn't get any of that in terms of comprehension. Who are we talking about that you can't say whether she'll be here next month?
Melissa,
the
dog grooming business,
dog grooming
from last
business.
Month.
Okay, dog grooming.
She will not be here for... I don't know. Indeterminate amount of mine. I'm just saying limbo because of the state licenses, we don't know when she'll be here.
Okay.
There is a business that will likely be here in April, but no promises.
Mm-hmm.
So in terms of March's planning board meeting, the only business that I know of was doing a pre-application tonight.
Okay.
Was Harvest Moon.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that is it for me, unless you want town gossip.
Oh, dear. Well, I don't know if we want to do that, but I do.
I have
noticed the sign on the old crematorium business place about a vape shop. Is
that
on your radar?
Yep. So that business up there is going to be a vape shop, I think.
And a
used car sales place. That's...
Whoa, there's a combo I hadn't thought of. Okay.
Oh, I thought you said vape
and
shop.
And that is,
I thought
that's
you did
CEO
I
approval.
Technically,
so.
I guess.
Uh-huh.
Really?
Yes.
But isn't it a business change from that store?
You would think.
It used, I mean, it's, and it's been
they're,
five
they're,
years since it's been.
They're allowed uses, though, for a CEO permit, so
yeah.
It doesn't need a planning board.
It would the business, the building would still be retail, so nothing there.
Oh,
and
so
the
it's still retail. So
why did the office come in? The insurance guy come in?
Because he was changing a use from a restaurant to an office space.
And offices require planning board review.
Okay.
So the crematorium, whatever that place was, it was an office, so it's going from office to retail.
Well, it wasn't the crematorium. It was the...
lace shop?
No, the building, the they sold the...
fasteners?
You know, screws and bolts, whatever
it
was
called. Well, that's a different place.
No, that was the one where they're having the vape shop.
Oh.
The little ranch that, like, the...
Oh, yeah, yeah, oh.
That's still for sale.
Oh, I guess.
This was
okay.
The
Fastenal. Okay. Yep, oh, that's right. Like that. So
the crematorium, then, is not the vape shop.
No,
what's
no,
right?
I had it wrong. I'm sorry. It was the fastener.
The old fastener. They,
so
they
it's
sold
retail
fasteners
to retail.
Correct.
Yeah.
Retail to retail, so that covers the vape. And then the used car, it's CEO in that district anyways. So
used cars doesn't...
Doesn't require. In
that district, it's CEO.
CEO, yeah.
Okay. Wow, okay.
Maybe there are cars running on vapors.
For a fact. You've had the best running commentary. Tonight,
yeah, really.
Sarah. I've got to applaud you, really.
I know. It's hard to beat the porta potty one, but I'll tell you. But.
I just think those things.
I go to that state sale every month. That would be a first.
They just finished taking them out. Because my wife and I were part timers for so long, and we would be, you know, drive up and you could, you'd go through the New Hampshire, you know, everybody in, from Pennsylvania to here switched to the automatic toll paying, you know, with the little easy pass, except Maine. So I pulled in one time and I'm giving the guy on, you know, on the turnpike, the first toll, exit 7 or wherever it is, and, you know, and I said, so when are you guys going to get an easy pass? And he said, roundabout when the outhouses come out. And so laughed and drove away. Oh. And it took another 7 years, but they finally did it. Okay.
Well, that's it for town planner.
Okay. Comments from planning board members.
You know what I'm going to say.
Happy Valentine's Day.
I will entertain a motion that we adjourn.
All right. I second the motion.
All in favor?
Hee-hee.
Motion carries. Awesome. Thank you, everybody. That was...